Nobody plays guitar like this guy.
Hey, are you ready to learn how to play Running on Faith by Eric Clapton? Oh man, this is a great song. I didn't even remember it until I heard that little intro at the very beginning. Then I said, oh yeah, that brings back all kinds of memories. But hey, I'll tell you what, let me show you real quick. I'm going to play just a couple of bars of it, and then that'll maybe jar your memory too. Listen, it goes like this. Again, I just get carried away playing it. I love playing that intro so much. But hey, don't worry about that now. Let's just go ahead and learn it. I know you want to learn it. Get your pick, get your guitar, and meet me in the studio. I'm going to show you how to play Running on Faith by Eric Clapton. You're going to love this one. Okay, let me show you the chords that we're going to play. You're going to have a G chord, and you can either play it that way, or you can play that G with the two strings. So you got your pinky on the third fret of the first string, and your ring finger, third fret of the second string. Okay, then you use your index finger to pick up that second fret on 5 and middle third fret on 6. There's your chord diagrams are up there too. So you got a G chord, you got a D with an F sharp bass, and all that is a D chord, regular D, and you take your thumb and you put it on that second fret of that sixth string. It's a D with an F sharp bass. You got an E minor 7. Now there's a couple of ways to play this. You can play a regular, there's your E minor, okay, regular E minor, and you take that pinky and put it on that third fret of the second string to get it. But it might be easier because of the way we're gonna do the intro. I'm always telling you to use fingers with the chords. It's gonna help you change to the next chord. So I think it'd be easier in the intro, at least, if you also get used to using your index finger, and you can just put it on that.
Make sure you had to do the opening riff for the song now. And I've got the tabs up there for you on the screen.
And these, you don't have to play it exactly like this. This kind of plays the chord pattern. If you want to just do some finger picking with a G, D, E minor, the way the chords are, and I'll show you that a little bit later, you can do it that way. But this is the way he's playing it, so I thought it might be cool. This is the wow factor part of this. Okay, now watch your tabs, and I'm going to play it for you one time through, and then we'll go back and do it note by note. So here it goes like this. Now let me show you note by note. And what we're going to do is I'm going to go through the first four notes right now. So look at those first four notes. I'll highlight them on the tab for you. But it goes like this. What you want to do is put your, actually like you're going to put a G chord. You can form your G, but the only notes that you're going to be playing on the first four, you'll notice you're going to play the sixth string, the open four, the third fret on that first string, and you're back to an open four. So it's like this. 1, 2, 3, 4. Those are your first notes. 1, 2, 3, 4. And then you go and you quickly change to a D chord and you just pick down 1, 2, 3, 4 strings, okay? And then you hit that open 6 again. So you got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, open 6. Okay, so what is that? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Okay, so the first 9 notes. Let's try that again. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Okay, now he doesn't stop, but now we're going to look at that next little section. They go. And all you got to do there is you're going to take your ring finger, and it's going to go on that third fret of that second string. So you got that open 6, then that open 4 again. Okay, so you got, let's start it, let's try that one more time. Open 6, open 4, 3 on 2, open 1, 3 on 2, open 3, open 4. Let's try that whole section now, all the way to what we just went through there. So start with that.